Hi, I'm Dr. Michelle Lee, a board-certified ophthalmologist, and today I'm joined by Dr. Caitlin Morrison, an optometrist and owner of InFocus Specialty Contact Lens and Vision Solutions in Scottsdale, Arizona. Today we are going to address a confusing question. What's the difference between an optometrist and an ophthalmologist? And who should I see for my eye exam?
I became an optometrist because I had a lot of issues wearing contact lenses myself as a kid, and I wasn't able to successfully wear contact lenses for a very long time. Because of that, I became an optometrist and now help my patients see well and comfortably all day with contact lenses, and as you can see, I now wear contact lenses myself. To become a doctor of optometry, you go through 4 years of college, 4 years of optometry school, and an additional optional residency or fellowship year where you are trained in a subspecialty.
Meanwhile, ophthalmologists are MDs who undergo general medical training as well as residency training specific to medical eye care and eye surgery. This includes 4 years of college, 4 years of medical school, 1 year of a medical or surgical internship, 3 years of ophthalmology residency, which includes hands-on clinical and surgical training, and an optional 1 to 2 years of extra subspecialty training. So who should I see for my eye exam?
For your general or primary eye care, both optometrists and ophthalmologists are more than qualified to screen for common eye diseases, check for glasses, and perform medical eye examinations. Both are trained to screen out vision-threatening and life-threatening eye diseases and to refer to a subspecialist if needed. If you need medical intervention like eye drops, oral medication, or monitoring of your ocular conditions, both optometrists and ophthalmologists can help you.
While there are some ophthalmologists who are comfortable dispensing contact lenses, this is not a formal part of ophthalmology training, and many ophthalmologists would rather leave this skill set to their optometry colleagues.
During optometry school, we get a lot of training in contact lenses and specialty contact lenses. Some optometrists, like myself, will elect to undergo an additional residency or fellowship year for extra hands-on training for skills like contact lens fittings and specialty contact lenses for eyes that are disfigured or have progressive conditions.
What if I'm not sure what's going on with my eye?
An optometrist will know when to refer you for a surgical consult with an ophthalmologist. The most common eye surgery is cataract surgery, where many surgeons will co-manage your care with your optometrist.
A good optometrist and ophthalmologist will know when to refer you for a subspecialty trained eye care provider. These are providers who are trained to treat certain eye conditions such as retinal diseases, eyelid abnormalities, glaucoma, or corneal conditions.
There is a lot of overlap between optometrists and ophthalmologists, and we are all eye care professionals with extensive training. Your primary eye care provider is like your primary care doctor and will be managing your eyes for years. The most important thing for best care isn't what degree your eye doctor has, but that you feel comfortable and have trust and a good rapport with your doctor.
Thanks for watching our collaboration. You can check out Dr. Morrison's Instagram linked below for daily eye care tips. And if you like this video, please like and subscribe because Dr. Morrison is going to come back to this channel soon to talk about her specialty, scleral contact lenses, and you won't want to miss it.
I'll see you in my next video.